Good afternoon and welcome to this session on demonstration of Bhuvan Panchayat geoportal. So I'll not be taking the much PPT slides here. Directly I'll be going to the portal and will show you what is this portal and how you are going to work on that. And our main focus will be on the asset mapping, and in the second part of my demonstration I'll be taking on the activity planning. So as you are aware, ISRO is having one earth observation geo portal called Bhuvan, and this portal can be accessed through the URL bhuvan.nrsc.gov.in. And this portal focused on basically right from the geo visualization to data processing in internet domain, and all the geospatial data tools, especially GIS tools, are available in the browser environment. So you can visualize the satellite data sets, you can visualize the outcome of these satellite data set in the form of maps and also the reports. And there are many theme specific applications available there, and these applications basically targets on the user's requirements, how they can use this space technology for their day-to-day activities. So Bhuvan Panchayat portal is one of the component of Bhuvan geo portal, and if you see the, I will just share my screen here. So if you see the Bhuvan portal as such, as I told you, the URL of this website bhuvan.nrsc.gov.in, and you may be aware of various component of Bhuvan geo portal, right from Bhuvan 2D to the theme specific applications. But today our objective is to focus on one of the important components which is available under the application sectors. You can see here my mouse, I am just overlaying here. So there is something called e-governance. So under the e-governance we have the decentralized planning link, and this link will redirect us to the Bhuvan Panchayat portal. So if you click on the decentralized planning, in the next step it is going to load the Bhuvan Panchayat portal. So this is a home page, basically map viewer of the Bhuvan Panchayat portal. Here you can see, in first look you can see that it is looking like any online map viewer, and the URL of this portal, if you wish to access directly, so you can always visit the link called www.bhuvan-panchayat.nrsc.gov.in. I hope this link is visible to you now. So here in this portal basically we focus on the concept of the decentralized planning, what we are discussing since morning today. So at the different level of the administrations, right from panchayat to state level, how you can plan or how you can involve the citizen in the planning activities. And this is the main objective of this particular initiatives. So here basically our purpose of this portal is basically demand of the specific solutions, information at respective level, geospatial data sets we are trying to make available to the users, flow of information, coordination among the stakeholders, transparency and participation, and good governance. These are the basic objectives basically what we have kept in mind when design the Bhuvan Panchayat geo portal. So let us directly go to the geo portal, how and what kind of information is available here. So now if you see here, once you open this bhuvan-panchayat.nrsc.gov.in, you will be seeing that in the left side the list of GIS layers, basically these are the maps in the form of map, you can overlay by clicking on this button, basically select button. Right side in this viewer, you are seeing the original map, and this map is not a static image, it is an interactive GIS map. You can increase the zoom level of this map and it will load the better quality of data based on the availability of the data. So, if you see the left side, first category is available called satellite imagery. If you switch on the option called satellite imagery, so it says that IIRS imagery. What does it mean? It is a Indian remote sensing satellite imagery. So, when I am saying IIRS imagery, it gives you the spatial visualization of this imagery at various resolution, that is spatial resolution, right from your 56 meter resolution to 1 meter spatial resolution, the data sets are available. So, when I am saying the resolution, this data set basically we are taking from the Indian remote sensing satellite called resource set 1, resource set 2 and cartosat series of satellite. So, and how we can visualize the satellite imagery at the various level. So, left side again in the map viewer itself, you have the zoom toolbar. So, you can increase your zoom level by clicking the plus button and you can decrease the zoom level by clicking on the minus button. You can also use the scroll button of your mouse to see the closer view of the any area. So, this is very simple way you can start working on the geo portal as per the satellite data visualization is concerned. So, whenever you are going closer to the location, so the more information will be loaded. For example, if you are viewing the data in the national level, right now if you see what I am trying to show you, the national map entire India as a unit, then you are able to see only the state boundaries here. These state boundaries are displayed as a black color, and then when you go to the closer view of the area, so you will be seeing that more data sets. Now you can see the some labels with the some purple colors are displayed here. These are the, now you can see the districts. So, next administrative unit in India after state is a district. So, district maps with the district boundaries are available. So, this way you can keep on going closer to the your location, so then more information will be getting loaded. You will also be observing here, when you are loading the data, it will load the vectors basically. These are called vector, what district boundary, state boundary and these things I am showing you. But same time it will also load the better quality satellite imagery. As I told you, 56 meter to 1 meter spatial resolution. So, at the various zoom level, this data set will be loaded. So, this is a basically satellite data visualization. Next part of the visualization is digital elevation model. When I am saying DEM, you may be aware of DEM concept. This is basically, it will show you the variation of height. Since you are right now visualizing this entire map in two-dimensional view, so the height information is displayed in the form of the map. So, here the different colors you are seeing, and the left side it will show the legend for that. Basically, if you see here the green color, so is the low height area, and if you see the other color like your gray or dark gray, this shows the area with the more elevation or high area where the height is more. So, you can also see the data in the next form called the hillside view. So, here what we did, we dragged this DEM data with the satellite image and created the shade view map. So, after seeing this, you will have the better visualization of the high terrain areas where the terrain is complex or it is a planar area and so on. So, this is the way the height information you can visualize. So, there are two methods are available. As I told you, the administrative boundaries right from state to cadastral map, this option is given. But as of now, up to the village level, data sets are available for entire country. And when I'm saying the village boundaries, these boundaries are also linked with the census data 2011. So entire country, this data information is available. But as per the cadastral maps are concerned, we are in process to make available the cadastral map for all the state of the country. But right now, only for Andhra Pradesh, Telangana and Kerala, these three states, we have just uploaded the cadastral map, which you can easily visualize it. The next part of this visualization is, we are telling that constituencies, basically parliaments and assembly constituencies are also available. These boundaries you can overlay on the satellite data. And once you overlay the satellite data, right now you can see that different constituencies are available. And these boundaries you can visualize as per the parliament, as per the assemblies are concerned. So, the regions are also available. The same thing, different important schemes of Government of India, like Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana, and the next program what we link is Backward Region Grant Funds, BRGF. These data sets are also linked with your particular satellite data visualization. Now, you see the Sansad Adarsh Gram Yojana under this program. So, two categories we are displaying here. These are the villages adopted by Lok Sabha MPs and villages adopted by Raj Sabha MPs. So, this was a one of the very important initiative of our government, and where our honorable prime ministers has requested all the member parliaments that to adopt the village for their sustainable development. So, these villages are highlighted here. You can always visualize and query on that. Similarly, the next category also is available. Now, come to the thematic data set. Under this category, the first category is a drainage and water bodies. Very important information, and this information is available for entire country. So, you can click on the plus button, and further you can see the next categories like drainage and water bodies state wise on 1:50,000 scale, drainage and water body on district wise on 1:10,000 scale. This information is available, and same time you can also search for a water body or drainage by selecting your administrative unit. Since here the time will be very, very short, I may not able to show you the all the capability, but just for your information, you can choose your administrative unit and write from state, then district, then block or tehsil and panchayat level, the water body information can be visualized. So, this way you can use it. And then I was trying to load the from the Andhra Pradesh and district wise information, if you see. So, this way you can overlay. And next part of this thematic data is land use and land cover data set. Sometime we are also calling it LULC data. So, there was some questions before this session. I was trying to see your questions, what is LULC? LULC is basically talk about land use and land cover data set. And these are basically maps what we derived using the satellite remote sensing data. And at the different scale, right, 1:250,000 scale, 1:50,000 scale, 1:10,000 scale, these data sets are available, and you can always overlay these data sets here in this particular map viewer. So, when I am overlaying the land use land cover data sets, say at 1:50,000 scale, so it is not only the visualization, since it is a GIS enabled data sets, so you can also perform the various queries on these data sets. Say that I am interested on the that particular state, I am interested on particular district, or sometime you can also draw your area of interest, and the system will give you the information that what is the status of land use land cover on that area. And when you are doing these activities, so you can choose the land use land cover status at the administrative unit wise. You can also select based on the hydrological units, or sometime you can also search through your custom search. So this is the options available for the area selections. Now as per the 1:50,000 scale is concerned, so you can see the left side, different land use classes are also available. So right from the built up urban to different agriculture, you have the forest, you have the barren lands, you have wetlands and water bodies, snow and glacier, and these all informations will be displayed. So this is about the 1:50,000 scale. And the 1:50,000 scale, the latest data of 2010-11 time period is available. And the same time, this land use land cover data on the 1:10,000 scale under the project what was presented by Dr. Nagaraja just before my session on the space-based input for decentralized planning. Under this projects, we are creating the 1:10,000 scale map on by using the CartoSat series of satellite data sets. It's available here. You can also show the slope map. You can link the infrastructure. You can link the hydrological unit. Different hydrological units are also available. And the under the legacy data, we have the ground water prospect map. You may be knowing that ISRO is having one of the very ambitious program on national mission on drinking water mission. Rajiv Gandhi National Drinking Water Mission. Under this programs, whatever the groundwater prospect maps are generated, these data set directly available for overlay here. So always you can see that GWP groundwater prospect map district wise on 10,000 scale also is available. Under the NUIS project, we have created these data sets. So you can keep on browsing these data sets here. And then legacy data, and let me close few of the windows because screen resolution is very limited here. And now the soil depth, land capability classification, soil texture and so on, this is all about the data sets available in the Bhuvan Panchayat portal. So please spend some time on the left part of this screen where we have written as a layer. So you can explore these layers in details, and if you are selecting a panchayat for this asset mapping, these data sets will be very important and useful for you to do your exercise of the asset mapping. And also these data sets further you will be using for when you will be participating in the activity planning, what I will be demonstrating in the evening session, where the same platform can be used for various activity planning related tasks. There we will be seeing that how this data can be useful. So this is about the availability of the data sets. Now if you go to the top menu where you are seeing that SysDP, area selections, area profile report, asset mapping, activity planning, implementation and monitoring, download, share view, these are the important toolbars customized only for the requirement of the our SysDP project and also as per the requirement of the panchayat level decentralized planning. In down to this particular toolbar, we have few technical tools available for you. If you click on the navigation, you have pan, zoom in, zoom out, zoom box, previous extent, full extent and search utility. I think most of the people are aware of these tools. If not, so quickly I will tell you. So when you are choosing the pan buttons, for example this, so you can move your map left, right, top and down. So this way this basically pan will help you to play with map to just move the map location. Zoom in, basically this particular tool will help you to go to the closer view of the map. If you click on the zoom, this is a plus button. You will be see, I hope you must be observing now, the it is showing the closer view of the location. Similarly, if you are clicking on this zoom out, so now you can see it is decreasing the zoom level. So this way, and these two tools are similar to the plus and minus button or slider shown in the left side. These are the same functionality where you are seeing it. Next tool is zoom box. Zoom box is basically, if you draw a small box here, so only that part it is going to zoom. It's just another functionality. So you can say that I am interested to zoom on this particular location, then automatically it is going to perform this operation. Now next is a previous extent. So last zoom level it will show you, and search option basically can allow you to search a particular location. Say suppose you say that I am interested to search a area called Dehradun. So you simply type the spelling, so it is going to suggest you the possible names, and then you can pick this name and then automatically it will zoom. This is one way, by typing the place name you can zoom to the location. Second option what is available here is zoom by position. When it is a position, then you have to provide your coordinate. This is my longitude, this is my latitude, so automatically it will zoom. So if you are aware of the latitude and longitude of your panchayat, what you are going to take for the mapping activity, then simply provide the latitude and longitude of this location, it is going to zoom to your panchayat automatically. So next is measurements. These are basically two tools are given here, length and area. So when I am seeing the length, you simply select it and start drawing. So it will simply show you the it will measure the distance between two points, and sometime if required it will measure the area of a polygon what you are trying to draw into the map. So this is about the tool on this person. And the personalization is another group of tool which will allow you to perform some operation like on click on the features. If you want extract the information, you please use the identify. If you are interested to perform some queries, you can design your query and then it will display the outcomes. You can put a markers that this is my area of interest or this is my particular location where I am going to do the mapping activity. So you can drop a points. Sweeping tool is another very interesting tools. What you can do, you can keep two layers together, one satellite, second map, and then you can sweep. You can see that what is behind one layer. So transparency you can set, go to my area and so on. So drawing tools are also available. You can draw the point, you can draw the line, you can draw the polygon and so on. Now this all about the tools. Now come to the next component called area selections. If you click on the area selections, so you can choose the area based on the administrative units, based on the hydrological unit, based on the constituency, based on the general search. You can search for a place. And if you create on the area profile, here you have dashboard, and the profile is basically related to the like climate data. You can view the climate data for the selected area, and this data is available in the form of the grid and also in the form of the district. Interactive area reports, basically you can, I will be showing you how you can operate on that. It's basically you can design your area of interest, then you can get the complete report on that. And the print area report, here directly the reports are available in the form of the PDF. You can directly print and use it. But the most important component of this portal for this training workshop is the asset mapping. When I'm saying the asset mapping, here you can see some assets like map assets. Under the map assets, you have categories like civic amenities, infrastructure assets, government assets, you have the productive assets, and you can also see the all the assets whatever you have mapped. You can generate the report, okay, as a citizens, as a PRI. You can also generate the report and you can also see the historical report, what kind of assets were available at that particular locations. You can design the a very specific query, or a query builder is available to generate the reports. To do this activity, first you have to register. So registrations, basically when you are clicking on the register button, so there are two methods available for registration. One method is you simply come to this website and give your names and type, user types, I will explain you, and some basic information, register it. Same registration you can perform through the mobile applications. When you are downloading the Bhuvan Panchayat mobile application from this portal, then directly you can also perform the registration activity, and automatically that you will be registered. The same registration will be used in mobile application and also the web application. Now if you see how to register here, so name is a mandatory fields. For example, suppose you are saying that my name is Harish, and as a citizen or as a village PRI, as a block PRI, as a district PRI, Panchayati Raj institution, basically we are talking about it. So suppose I am getting involved in the asset mapping activity, so of course I am going to first level I am going to register as a citizen. So citizens are getting involved in the this mapping activity. Here the approach is participatory approach we are adopting, and which is known as also as a crowdsourcing approach. So once you select your registration type, I have selected as a citizen, so I can give my telephone number. So for example, any number you can give, you can also enter your email. So address is optional. So here name, registered as, telephone number and email are basically mandatory. For address is optional. So if you see the area selection, you can always say that I belongs to a particular area like Uttarakhand. So once state is selected, it will ask you select your district. I am saying that I am right now in Dehradun district. So then next level it says that your block or tehsil. I can choose my block and tehsil, and if panchayat data is available, up to panchayat level you can do the selection job. Then about the login credentials, I have to type any logins. For example, I can say that IIRS demo, and the password I can keep any password, and of course you have to retype the password for confirmation, and now you can register it. So this, that much only, the registration process is very simple. Once it is done, the message is registration success, please log in to register. So you have to activate also your account, so you will be getting the email for this purpose. So you just check your email, then you will be getting the your confirmation message that you are successfully registered with Bhuvan Panchayat portal. So this is the first step what you have to perform before doing the asset mapping activity. I hope it must be clear now. So you can also retrieve your password. Sometime if you missed your password, you can simply retrieve it by giving your username and email address. So password will be sent to your email address. So in later stage also you can do this exercise. So this is a registration process. Once you have logged in or you have successfully registered and your login is activated, so you can choose this particular login to credential to log into the Bhuvan Panchayat. Now just to demonstrate you the full capabilities of the asset mapping activities, so I am going to show you or demonstrate you one of the panchayat in Uttar Pradesh where the complete set of data sets are available for demonstration purpose, and also you can create similar kind of data set for your own panchayat what you are going to select it. So first we'll go to these particular locations by selecting area selections. So by administrative units I am going to select a particular panchayat, say in the Uttar Pradesh. So all the district of UP will be loaded here, then we will be going to the tehsil, and finally we will reach to the panchayat. So right now I am accessing this portal live, so data is coming from Hyderabad server. So it depends on the internet speed. If you have the good connectivity, so immediately data is going to load. So I am waiting to connect it. So it is connected. So let me try again. So Uttar Pradesh I am selecting. Then I am going to select the a particular district, say Varanasi district. And then I am going to select a tehsil, and within tehsil a particular panchayat I will be choosing, and once it is through, so I will be reaching especially at that particular location with the boundary of the panchayat. Now let us wait for the loading data. So now going to the panchayat and I will say go. So when I click on the go, it is going to zoom now. You see this is a panchayat boundary. I think I have switched on many layers, that's why it is taking time. So I will switch off some of the layers, the village boundary I will keep, panchayat boundary I will keep, I think land use may not required at this moment. Yeah, drainage I will remove, land use remove, I will remove the slope. So it was taking time because I have loaded lot of data. So you can see this is one village panchayat called Jaipur Panchayat in Varanasi district. You can see the green color boundaries basically are showing the panchayat boundary. These boundaries basically we have created by merging the villages coming under this panchayat. The village boundaries were available and simply we merge it. Boundary may not be accurate, this is just approximation of the data representation. We are in process to improve these boundaries by getting more authentic data. But if you see the information, whatever is available, what is the best information available with us, based on this we have clubbed the villages coming under a respective panchayat and created the panchayat boundary. So you can see here nicely the data set on 1 meter spatial resolution from the Cartosat series of satellite is loaded for this particular panchayat, and I am able to see the different land use features. You can see right now the different settlement locations, houses. You can also nicely see the road networks in this particular map. Further you can go closer to the map viewer. I hope the data must be getting loaded at your end also. So here the very nicely you can identify the land features, and you are ready to map these features here. So this is a very simple way how you can zoom to a particular panchayat. You please try for your own panchayat or near to your location. I hope you will be getting this kind of look. And please remember here the Cartosat data on 2.5 meter is available for entire country. However, data for 1 meter resolution is available for only selected panchayat and towns right now, but we are in process to publish this kind of this quality of data for entire country. Shortly it will be available, but right now 2.5 meter data also will be giving you a good quality visualization of the different land features, which is sufficient to do the mapping on 1:10,000 scale. So now if you see here, so this kind of area selection you can do, and in this area selection, after this you have to click on the asset mapping button, and on the asset mapping, since already I am zoomed to these locations by selecting my panchayat, so for this panchayat, as a citizen, if I have already registered, so same registration I am using here, so I can give my login. Now it says that as a Jaipur citizen you are logged in, and I can always see my profile, and since I have selected the tool called asset mapping, so it is showing me the all the asset mapped for this panchayat with red color. And you can always go to the better quality zoom level, increase or decrease the zoom level. Okay, if you are aware of the locality, you can easily pick the important asset in the browser itself. This is here a browser based platform is available in the right side. I hope you are able to see. You can see that different categories, around 226 asset under the civic amenities, around 35 asset under the government assets, and 10 assets under the productive assets are available. So this is a total number of asset, type of asset what you can map. If you click on the civic amenities, I hope you are getting this view. After clicking on the plus button, right side you are seeing that bank and insurance and credit societies, education facilities, general assets, medical and health facility, others, postal and telecom service, power and energy, sanitation and sewerage facility, transport, veterinary, water resource, and so on. Again, under this, if you click on the bank and insurance, we have the bank, ATM, insurance company, credit society, and financial institution. Again, under the education, if you click on this, you will be seeing that primary school, commerce, arts, engineering college, medicals, management, ITI, polytechnic, and so on. So different classifications are available. So you can pick any type. Say suppose in this particular area there is something called one ITI is available. So this is one of the important asset for any village where the education facility is concerned. So now you have to understand one important point here, that is called the geometry. Whenever you are getting involved in mapping activity, the most important thing is under which geometry you are going to create or you are going to map this particular asset. So there are three options available in the geospatial domain. One called as a point geometry, second called as a line geometry, third called as a polygon geometry. So in general, the point geometry will be using to identify a location as a point. So I may not able to digitize the exact boundary of these features, so I am presenting this as a point. Say example is ATM, so or a college, if this is a very or a school, the school is very small building is available, I can present it as a point. If I am able to identify the school as a polygon feature, or I am able to identify a area of this school boundaries, so I can draw a polygon also. And in case of some linear features like roads, like your river, drainage, rail networks, you can use the line geometry. So here you have to think it and then apply your mind. So under which geometry I can map this particular feature. So here I have selected ITIs. I am saying that this can suppose just choose it and click on this point. You can see here when I am clicking on the map, so automatically the coordinate of this location will be picked by my computer, and then I can fill the different attribute which needs to be geocoded for this particular map features. So I have selected the ITIAJ features, and then I can give the name of the features. If any program is linked with this institute, like certificate level programs, undergraduate, postgraduate, or doctorate, or whatever. Since it is ITI, of course, the certificate level programs will be linked with this. Then course offered by this particular ITI, you can write in comma, comma, separated things. What type of courses are there, like for boys, for girls, for co-education, you can opt for this. Who is running this? It's run by central government, state government, deemed or private, and others category, you can choose it. Then building ownership, either this particular asset is running on the rented buildings, or it is owned by the institute itself, or other category, you can always choose it. You have to fill the number of students, like male and female students, number of teachers, male and female. These all attributes are defined. You may not get the full details when you are getting involved in this asset mapping activity. So whatever best information you are getting, because for this purpose you have to contact to the maybe respective principal of the institute to get this information. So that job you have to do it. So here you can only identify the feature, but actually the asset mapping, you have to go to the ground with your mobile device and pick this geographic coordinate and fill this form. And this complete form visualization or filling opportunities are also available in the mobile device. So both the way you can do it. And in later stage, if you feel that sometime I have not filled the correct information, then you can also edit this information directly in this web page itself. So this is the way basically you will be doing the mapping exercise as per the asset is concerned. So please remember, I told the different categories of assets are readily available under the three major categories, and then further we have the few subcategories, and there you like under the productive categories we have the agriculture system, forest industries, mining and quarrying and other. So basically three major categories are available under which you have to choose the asset for your mapping exercise. So point, line and polygon geometries are available, and the right side the complete data structure for attribute will be displayed, then you can continue it. So you can also search for the assets already mapped. Like if you see already done mapping for this particular panchayat, what I have selected here, like one asset under the ATM category is mapped. Under the Aganwadi, only one Aganwadi is there. Under the agricultures, we have one agricultures asset, and then bank and so on. These all the categories for that particular location is also available, that we can search. Already mapped assets are also visible, and this is basically status for my login as a citizen when I am logged into my system. So how much mapping I have completed. For example, for religious place I have mapped 1, and road transport facility 4, tubewells 14 I have asset mapped. So this is basically showing the status of my task what I have completed as of now. So that also you can perform like identification of the assets. Okay, so this is just selecting asset and querying on that. So this is a basically tool to do the mapping activities. I hope it should be clear, because the system is very simple, and we try to make it a very user friendly tool so that you can continue your mapping activities for the your given task and or assignment. Now again I am just refreshing the page. So I'm here again. So now once you complete this task of the asset mapping, you can also view the assets, or basically you can say that it is a query builders. And if I have completed the mapping for the like religious places 1 and tubers 14 and other road transport and extra categories, so I can always see, and these all the details are available in the red color. I hope you are able to see it, and I can also perform the query on that. Still it is loading the data. Yeah, this was a visualization part. So I can query. If you click on the query option, so it is going to give you the right hand side one toolbar for query activities. So now this is the data sets. Okay, fine. So visualization and mapping part is complete. So activity part planning I will be taking in the next session. Now spend few more minutes on the download section, which is very important for you. So this is a very quick demonstration on the activity on the asset mapping, how you can do using the Bhuvan Panchayat portal. Now when you are doing this exercise, the download section will be very important for you. Here most important part is mobile applications, how you can download. And this complete mapping activity, whatever I was trying to show you, the same thing you can perform in your own mobile phones, which is a Android based mobile phones. So this APK file is available here. By clicking on this link, you can download. You can always download the map books. Very interesting feature here. So right now I am logged in as a Jaipur village citizens, so I can download the different type of data set, like if it is a cadastral map, drainage, and I can choose my layer. So I can print this map book. This is basically atlas kind of utility. So for the local computer or for your future reference also, you can use this particular map book that can be downloaded here. And this map book available in the A4 size and A3 size. For better kind of quality printing and bigger quality printing, you can use the A3. And there are some utilities here. As a citizen, I don't have right to download the some of the reports, but as a different level of authorization, if it is like panchayat level and block level and district level, that time we have the various reports are also available, that I am going to show you in the next session when I'll be showing the activity planning. So this is the basically all about the asset mapping using the Bhuvan Panchayat portal. I hope it will be useful when you'll be taking this project. And now please start posting your questions on the this particular topics during the panel discussion. We'll be taking it. So thank you very much for your very active participation. I am seeing there are many questions coming from you, so we'll be compiling and taking in the during the our panel discussions. Please spend some time on this portal. If any difficulty, you can write to us. If any technical problems, we'll try to resolve it. and it's available under the main portal of the Bhuvan. So thank you very much. Thank you for your participation.